Father, this morning we give you thanks and we give you praise again, Lord, that you have granted us with another day of breath. And Father, as we come before your throne, your word says, enter my courts with thanksgiving and with praise. Lord, we just ask that you just fill us with your grace and fill us with your mercy, fill us with your love. And as the word goes forth this morning, Father, let our hearts be open to receive it. So Father, as we sing, let the praise and the glory be for your honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Sing a song, Swing Low Sweet Chariot. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Swing low, swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home.
Swing low,
Shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. Surely He will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. You will not fear the terror of night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in the darkness, nor the plague that destroys at midday. 1,000 may fall at your right side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you.
Amen.
You will only observe with your eyes and see the punishment of the wicked. If you make the Most High your dwelling, even the Lord who is my refuge, then no harm will befall you, no disaster will come near your tent. For he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. They will lift you up in their hands so that you will not strike your foot against the stone. You will tread upon the lion and the cobra. You will trample the great lion and the serpent. Because he loves me, says the Lord, I will rescue him. I will protect him, for he acknowledges my name. He will call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. This is God's word.
Amen.
God is there.
I love my Jesus.
Hallelujah.
We shall sing on that beautiful.
here this morning.
Amen.
Turn around to your neighbor and say, God bless you once more. Amen.
Amen.
Is not on our side. We want to go right away into the service. You may be seated. I want to introduce a few people. I have my friend Henri Malanda. We went to primary school together.
I want him to come, just take one mic and just greet the church. We went to high school together. We have not seen each other for 30 years. And he resides in Paris, he's a doctor in mathematics.
So we met together when we was kids at school, and we studied.
We met together when was kids at school and studied in the same classes before going to university, and at that time I was process diverged a little bit. She was for medicine, biology, and I was for mathematics. And after studying in Congo, I went to France till that time, from 1993, I stayed in France. I worked there, have a family, four children, three daughters, one boy, and I'm in United States for a week for a business, and I take this opportunity to spend 2 days in Denver to meet once again my brother, my friend, because there's a long time. We showed the picture we had when we was young, so face is not the same. It was very, very thin, not so, so totally different. So I'm very glad to meet you again, to meet you all, since I was not imagining that he's doing this kind of stuff. So that's all. So thanks a lot. And we have our brother Sharman. You stand, you all know him. Dr. Alan Lumu. We have Brother King and his beautiful wife. And always we have the Mabusu family there. God bless you. This morning we have Pastor John Mafuta from Brazzaville, or from heaven. And it's a blessing to receive it. He's also a personal friend of my brother. They went to school together. So it's like a school friend uniting again, something like that. So I'm really happy to see him here. And he's also a pastor. And God has been using him mightily. So we are happy to receive him and bring the word of God for us. God bless you. I am so happy to be among you this morning.
Et c'est la deuxième fois que je viens dans votre pays.
This is the second time that I'm coming to your country.
C'est la première fois que j'ai l'opportunité de venir dans votre église.
First time I have the opportunity to come in your church.
Votre pasteur, je le connais bien.
I know your pastor very well.
Quand il a quitté le Congo pour les États-Unis.
When he left the Congo for the United States.
C'est un ancien, comme on l'appelle.
He's an elder, like they say.
Il connaît ce message.
And he knows this message.
Quand il donne l'opportunité d'être au milieu de vous.
When he has the opportunity to be among you.
Ça veut dire que il veut que je vous apporte la parole.
He wants me being among you to bring you the word.
Et je demande à Dieu simplement de m'aider au milieu de vous. Je demande à Dieu de m'aider.
And I'm asking God to help me being among you.
Et je demande vos prières pour que la communion soit belle.
I'm asking for your prayer for beautiful fellowship.
Amen.
Ce n'est pas l'homme qui va parler.
It's not the man who's going to speak.
C'est l'Esprit de Dieu dans l'homme qui parle.
The Spirit of God in a man will speak.
Ne regardez pas l'homme.
Don't look at the man.
Mais regardez l'Esprit de Dieu.
Look at the Spirit of God.
Je suis le pasteur Jean Mafuta.
A pasteur Jean Mafuta.
J'ai une église à Brazzaville.
I have a church in Brazzaville.
La petite Bethlehem Tabernacle.
The little Bethlehem Tabernacle.
Je vis au Congo et en France.
I live in the Congo and also in France.
Toute ma famille, ma femme, mes enfants vivent en France.
All my family, my wife and the children live in France.
Pour le moment, je travaille encore.
Now I'm still working.
Et peut-être à la fin de quand je prendrai la retraite.
Maybe at the end when I retire.
Peut-être que je vais rejoindre ma famille.
I will join my family maybe.
Mais il faut que Dieu le veuille.
But it has to be God's will.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Je vous salue tous dans le nom de Jésus-Christ.
I greet you all in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. Je vous invite à vous lever pour que nous entendions.
And I ask you to stand so that we can go into the word.
Nous allons prendre nos Bibles.
We're going to take our Bible.
Nous allons lire dans deux écritures et vous allez vous asseoir, je lirai la troisième écriture.
We're going to read two scriptures, then you'll sit down and then I'll read the third one.
Marc chapitre 16.
We go to the book of Mark 16.
Nous lirons du verset 2 à 7.
We read from verse 2 to verse 7.
Et nous prendrons le verset 14 à 19.
And we take 14. Do 19.
Je demanderai au pasteur de prier pour la lecture de la parole.
And I ask the pastor to pray for the reading of the word.
Et vous allez vous asseoir.
And then you'll sit.
Je lirai la troisième écriture.
And I'll read the first scripture.
Disons la parole de Dieu, Marc 16.
Let's read the word of God, Mark 16.
Verset 2 à 7.
Beginning from verse 2 to 7.
Le premier jour de la semaine.
Very early morning of the first day of the week.
Elles se rendirent au sépulcre.
They came to the tomb.
Le grand matin comme le soleil venait de se lever.
When the sun had risen.
Élisée entre elles.
And they said among themselves.
Qui nous roulera la pierre loin de l'entrée du sépulcre?
Who will roll away the stone from the door of the tomb for us?
Et levant les yeux.
But when they looked up.
Elles aperçurent que la pierre qui était très grande.
They saw that the stone that was big.
Avait été roulé.
Had been rolled.
Elles entrèrent dans le sépulcre.
And they went into the tomb.
Vit un jeune homme assis à droite vêtu de robe blanche.
So a young man clothed in long white robe.
Et elles furent épouvantées.
Sitting there and they were alarmed.
Il leur dit.
But he said to them.
Ne vous épouvantez pas.
Do not be alarmed.
Vous cherchez Jésus de Nazareth.
You seek Jesus of Nazareth.
Qui a été crucifié.
Who was crucified.
Il est ressuscité.
He's risen.
Il n'est point ici.
He's not here.
Voici le lieu où on l'avait mis.
Where he was laid.
Mais allez dire à ses disciples.
But go tell his disciples.
Et à Pierre.
And Peter.
Qu'il vous précède en Galilée.
That is going to go before you into Galilee.
C'est là que vous le verrez.
There you see him.
Comme il l'a dit.
As he said to you.
Verset 14.
Verse 14.
Enfin, il apparut aux onze.
Then he appeared to the 11.
Pendant qu'ils étaient à table,
as they sat at the table,
il a reproché leur incrédulité,
and he rebuked them for their unbelief,
et la dureté de leur cœur,
and hardness of heart,
parce qu'ils n'avaient pas cru,
because they did not believe,
ceux qu'il avait vu ressusciter,
those who seen him after he had risen.
Oui, il a dit,
then he said to them,
allez par tout le monde.
Go into all the world.
Et prêchez la bonne nouvelle à toute la
création.
Celui qui croira,
he will believe,
qui sera baptisé,
and is baptized,
sera sauvé.
Will be saved.
Mais celui qui ne croira pas,
he who does not believe,
sera condamné.
Will be condemned.
Voici les miracles.
The other signs
qui accompagneront
will follow
ceux qui ont cru.
Them that believe.
En mon nom,
in my name,
ils chasseront les démons.
They shall cast out demons.
Ils parleront de nouvelles langues.
They speak a new tongue.
Ils saisiront des serpents.
They take up serpents.
Ils boivent quelques breuvages mortels.
And they drink any unwilling drink.
Ils ne leur feront point de mal.
Deadly drink, it will not hurt them.
Ils imposeront les mains malades.
They lay hand upon the sick.
Et les malades seront guéris.
And the sick shall recover.
Amen.
Ils imposeront les mains malades.
They shall lay hands upon the sick.
Et les malades seront guéris.
And the sick shall recover.
Le Seigneur, après leur avoir parlé,
the Lord, after he has spoken to them,
fut enlevé au ciel.
Was received into heaven.
Et il s'assit à la droite de Dieu.
And sat at the right hand of God.
Prions.
Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this beautiful day that you have given us the opportunity to come and hear, not a man, but hear the word of the living God. Father, I pray that the Holy Spirit lift us in heavenly places in Christ so that we can hear you, Jesus, the same yesterday, today, and forever. Bless the reading of your word. Bless the people. Heal the sick. Open our eyes so that we can see you. So that when we come out of here, we can say, did not our heart burn within us as he was talking to us? Father, we thank you. Amen. And we lift up the name of Jesus this morning. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Vous asseoir.
You may be seated.
Nous allons.
We take the last scripture
in Ephesians chapter 6.
In the book of Ephesians chapter 6,
verses 11 to 13.
Beginning from verse 11 to 13.
Ephesians chapter 6, verses 11 to 13.
Ephesians 6, from 11 to 13.
Revêtez-vous de toutes les armes de Dieu.
Put on the whole armor of God.
Afin de pouvoir tenir ferme contre les ruses du diable.
That you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil.
Car nous n'avons pas à lutter contre la chair et le sang.
For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood.
Mais contre les dominations.
But against principalities.
Contre les autorités.
Against powers.
Contre les princes de ce monde des ténèbres.
Against the rulers of darkness of this age.
Contre les esprits méchants.
Against the spiritual hosts of wickedness.
Dans les lieux célestes.
In the heavenly places.
C'est pourquoi.
Therefore.
Prenez toutes les armes de Dieu.
Take up the whole armor of God.
Afin de pouvoir résister.
That you may be able to withstand.
Dans le mauvais jour.
In the evil day.
Et tenir ferme.
And having done all.
Après avoir tout surmonté.
To stand.
Amen.
Amen.
Aimez-vous la parole?
Do you love the word?
Yes. Qui aime la parole, levez la main.
Who loves the word, lift up your hand.
Et qui croit que Jésus va agir ce matin?
Who believe Jesus is going to act this morning?
Que Dieu vous bénisse.
May God bless you.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Ce matin, je veux vous parler d'un petit sujet que j'ai intitulé.
This morning, I have another topic to tell you about. It's entitled
Le combat spirituel dans le message.
The spiritual warfare in the message.
Je dis bien dans le message.
I'm saying in the message.
Nous venons de lire les Écritures.
We read the scriptures.
Nous venons de voir que c'est des femmes.
We have seen that this time.
Sont allées à la tombe de Jésus.
The women went to the tomb of Jesus.
Pour aller apporter les arômes et les choses. Pour mettre sur Jésus.
To bring the arms and all the aromas and odors, perfumes.
Et quand ils arrivent,
when they arrived there,
la pierre avait déjà été roulée.
The stone was already rolled away.
Qui a coulé la pierre?
Who rolled away the stone?
Ils sont entrés.
And they went in.
Et trouve quelqu'un assis en robe blanche.
Found someone sitting in white robe.
Il leur dit.
And he told them.
Celui que vous cherchez.
The one, the whom that you seek it.
C'est Jésus de Nazareth.
It's Jesus of Nazareth.
Qui a été crucifié.
Was crucified.
Il est ressuscité.
But he is risen.
Il n'est plus ici.
He's not here anymore.
C'est une information.
That's some kind of information.
Qui peut porter beaucoup de questions.
It can bring a lot of questions.
Car Jésus était un homme quand il était en Galilée ou à Nazareth.
Because Jesus, when he was in Galilee, he was like a man.
Et depuis que l'homme a été créé sur la terre, personne n'a entendu dire que quelqu'un ressuscité.
Since man was created, never before they heard a man rise again like that.
Et quel est cet homme qui peut être ressuscité?
And what kind of a man was that that was risen?
Qui est-il?
Who is he?
Le monsieur qui était là,
the man who was there,
c'est un ange.
It was an angel.
Un ange particulier.
A particular angel.
Il vous a précédé en Galilée.
He preceded them in Galilee.
Allez, vous allez le rencontrer là-bas.
Go, he shall meet him.
C'est une parole.
It's a word.
Cette parole doit s'accomplir.
That word had to come to pass.
Celui qui a donné le message.
The one who gave the message.
Était sûr de sa parole.
He was certain of his word.
Il faut croire.
You must believe.
C'est pourquoi.
That's why.
Quand nous avons lu au verset 14.
When we read verse 14.
Jésus leur est apparu.
Appeared unto them.
Ça veut dire que la prophétie s'est accomplie.
It means the prophecy was fulfilled.
Celui qui était crucifié et qui était mort.
The one was crucified and was dead.
Et bien ressuscité.
Was really risen.
Ne soyez pas comme Thomas.
Don't be like Thomas.
Il faut que je voie.
He said, I must see.
Les traces des clous.
The trace of the nails.
Alors je croirai qu'il est bien ressuscité.
Then I believe that he is certainly risen.
Croyez Dieu sur sa parole.
Believe God upon his word.
Croyez Dieu sur sa parole.
You must believe God upon his word.
Quand Jésus est entré dans cette chambre.
When Jesus entered into that room.
Il trouve les disciples.
He found the disciples.
La première des choses qu'il a fait.
The first thing that is done.
Il est tout droit vers Thomas.
He went to Thomas.
Thomas l'incrédule.
Thomas, the unbeliever.
Quand la parole sort ici.
When the word is coming out of here.
Et il va tout droit à l'incrédule.
It will go to even to the unbeliever.
Amen.
Si vous êtes venu ce matin.
If you came this morning.
Et que vous venez comme un incrédule.
And you come like an unbeliever.
La parole s'adressera à vous.
The word will address itself to you.
Spécialement à vous.
Specially to you.
Thomas.
Thomas.
Pourquoi as-tu douté à ma parole?
Why did you disbelieve my word?
Serais-tu croire sans me voir?
You had to believe even without seeing me.
Heureux.
Blessed are those.
Ceux qui ont cru.
Who believe
sans voir.
Without seeing.
Vous êtes heureux.
You are blessed.
Amen.
Parce que vous n'avez pas vu Jésus.
Because you never saw Jesus.
Et qu'est-ce qui vous amène à y croire Jésus?
What is pushing you to believe Jesus?
C'est qu'il y a une relation spirituelle entre Jésus et vous.
It means there's a relationship. Amen. Between Jesus and you, a spiritual one.
Hallelujah.
Chaque semence.
Every seed.
Se reproduit selon son espèce.
Has to reproduce according to its own kind.
Si vous êtes la semence de Dieu,
if you are God's seed,
la Bible dit,
the Bible says,
mes brebis entendent ma voix.
My sheep hear my voice.
Et elles me suivent.
Yes, sir.
And
follow me.
Qu'est-ce que la voix de Dieu?
What is God's voice?
C'est la parole.
It's the word.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Mais Jésus a donné une dernière commission à vos disciples.
But Jesus gave the last commission to the disciples.
La dernière commission.
The last commission.
De Marc 16.
Mark 16.
Allez partout le monde.
Go into all the world.
Prêchez la bonne nouvelle.
Preach the gospel.
Celui qui croira.
He that believeth.
La condition.
That's the condition.
C'est d'abord de croire.
It's first to believe.
Et avant de croire,
before you believe,
il faut d'abord écouter.
You must hear.
Amen.
Car la foi,
because faith,
vient de ce qu'on entend.
Come at my hearing,
et ce qu'on entend,
and hearing,
vient de la parole de Christ.
Amen.
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 Car la profondeur appelle la profondeur. Vous n'avez jamais été chrétien aujourd'hui.
You've never been a Christian today.
Non.
No.
Vous l'avez été au commencement.
You've been Christian even at the beginning.
Avant la fondation du monde.
Before the foundation of the world.
Dieu vous connaissait.
God knew you.
Il vous a envoyé sur la terre.
Sent you on this earth.
Pour manifester sa gloire.
Amen.
Et lorsque vous rencontrez la parole.
When you meet the word.
Vous n'êtes pas surpris de la parole.
You are not surprised.
Parce que vous étiez la parole au commencement.
Amen. Amen.
Personne ne vient à moi.
Nobody comes to me.
Si le Père ne l'appelle premièrement.
Unless the Father calls him first.
On ne vient pas à Jésus qui veut.
You don't come just to Jesus.
On vient à Jésus celui qui est connu de Jésus.
You come to Jesus because you know that Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Je crois que ce matin.
I believe this morning.
Vous êtes de Jésus.
You are of Jesus.
C'est pourquoi vous êtes ici.
That's why you're here.
Si vous êtes de Jésus,
if you are of
et que
Jesus,
vous êtes ici,
and you're here,
alors Jésus doit vous parler.
Then Jesus must talk to you, speak to you.
Allez,
go
dans le monde entier,
into all of
apporter la bonne nouvelle,
and preach the gospel.
J'ai quitté le Congo.
I left the Congo.
Je vais en France.
I live in